It is early morning here at DC1, and me, Mark, and Jason are about to head out on a two-day road trip to visit a shop peening company and a heat treating company, all for the gears to make them more durable. I'll explain more later. I'm already late and they're waiting in the car, so let's get on a road trip, guys.
This works under an inert atmosphere and runs up to 600 degrees. It's got a basic rotating system. So this will run up to 1100 degrees.
Yeah.
And you can see it's like a modular
design. What, that whole line is there?
This whole line, yeah, the whole line is obviously. Deal at the front, it runs to the back, that's just to help with preheating, and then it exhausts out the front.
Cheers,
mate. So, how do you think they went, Jace?
Yeah, really well. Look, I think the kit itself is really well made, really neat, easy to control. It'll hook into the rest of the manufacturing control system really nicely. We've got a few open questions about the detail of the process and the process parameters and things, but things that we can sort out really quickly, so yeah, I'm pleased with that. Just crack on with it now. Brilliant. Get it ordered and get on with it.
Sounds good.
I wanted to jump in quickly and explain a little bit more about heat treating and why we're so big on it. The units that you've seen so far in the video are basically glorified ovens that go to an extreme temperature. This is so the gears can be heat treated, and because of that, the open faces can be hardened. We talked about copper plating in a previous video and explained why we copper plate so the rest of the gear isn't hardened the same as the open face of the teeth, to ensure that the gears aren't brittle but the teeth face are hardened. That's why we heat treat, and that's why we're looking at these units in this road trip. Right, so at this point in the trip, we decided to go to the hotel because it was getting late and we had an early morning appointment. And this is where things got interesting. I'm gonna roll the next clip and you'll get an idea for what I mean.
This is not nice, mate. Hold up. I nearly fell in.
I'll just text him.
Morning. Morning, Richard.
Jace, pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to
Milan?
Meet you.
Milan?
Milan, that's the one, yep.
Yeah.
Automatic and special systems,
yeah,
which shop peening falls into.
Technology to the application of a really nicely industrial engineered helicopter. Mm.
See a radius,
yeah.
And so this shop peening machine is peening into those pockets to stop fatigue cracks.
Yeah.
But even so, we do have an automatic refill system. Front and bulge the door.
Yeah.
So it's easy to load a single gear.
So generally, when we think about a material and its ultimate strength, we think about a steadily applied pressure until the piece breaks. But there can actually be another way that things fatigue and break. This other way that there can be fatigue and then destruction of a part is by loads repetitively coming off and on the object or piece. What can happen is because of this constant stress of change of load amount, there can become micro fissions or tiny, tiny microscopic cracks in the piece, thus meaning that there will be incidentally a sudden failure at some point in the life because of that fatigue. The science behind this is effectively those repetitive tensile stresses are pulling and prying on the material to such a degree that it creates a pushing apart, or should I say a pulling apart of the material, causing a micro fission or microscopic crack. Shot peening is where you take tiny little metal balls and you shoot them at the object or the surface of it. This causes compressive stresses, which in turn enables there to be a greater fatigue life on the overall piece. Well, that brings us to the end of our very productive road trip. Thanks for joining us. We all had a great time and I hope you guys did too. Stay tuned for the next video. There'll be another one shortly, guys.